Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of RV Bandwagon. Yes, well, welcome. Today, here I am inside of the fifth wheel. I don't often do videos inside the fifth wheel, but today I am. Why am I doing that? Because this is going to be featured in my next several videos, actually, you know, intermittent videos, I should say. The refurbishment of this particular fifth wheel. This is a 2000, 32 and a half foot Prowler fifth wheel triple slide. Bought it brand new back in 2000 and have been full-timing in it ever since. And it has its share of problems. I've done a lot of work to this to keep it alive for the last 15 years, but I've never done a complete refurbishment of it. And I wanted to go ahead and videotape a little bit before I got started. A lot of this is, you know, the old school look with the wood and all this. So I've seen some awesome examples online of people who have taken fifth wheels and RVs and really transformed them into some unique vehicles. And that's what I'm planning on doing here. It's going to be pretty cool when I'm done. Anyways, I'll talk to you more about what we're going to be doing. But I'm just kind of walking you through. You see, it's pretty big. Fifth wheel. We were looking at getting another one, but for, you know, the price, 20 grand, 22,000, that's a lot of money these days. And so we'd rather just put about 5 grand or so into this, is what we're figuring, to get it up to par. Last year I actually put a new roof on this, so that part is already done. I'm going to do some major work to the exterior seams. I'm replacing are redoing the whole front cap on this. I'll be pulling it off, putting new insulation in there, as well as many, many other things to get it ready for the winter time. I'd like to make this one self-contained a little more, off the grid status, as far as maybe doing solar to it and some other things, but I'll take you along. Remember, if you guys have any ideas, things that you think would help with the fifth wheel like this to make it better, more livable, especially in the winter time, because this one seriously is not set up for that, just go ahead and leave me some comments. I'm always open ears for good ideas and inspirational advice to make my projects go a little bit easier and smoother. But I just thought I'd show you the inside right now. This is just a brief roam around. I got a lot of work to do in here, but it's still a pretty nice rig, and I think I'm just going to take the time and effort to actually make it really awesome. So you guys stay tuned. I got more to show you on this video right about now. All right, folks, so here I am. I'm inside of a construction zone right now. And as you can see, I'm painting some murals back here. We're starting out with the Imperial Walker. This is actually going to be a whole Star Wars scene over on this side. And I just thought I'd show you before I got too far into it. This is the background of the Imperial Walkers. I'm going to do a few more highlights to it, and then I'm going to start blacking it in, and then we're going to move on to doing the Death Star and some X-Wing fighters, and it'll all be a lot of fun. So you guys stick around, stay tuned, and I'll show you as I progress. Here we go. Alright guys, so here it is. I've got the giant Imperial Walker kind of there, and I'm moving on down this way tomorrow with we're going to do Tatooine parts of the town. I'll be doing C-3PO, I'll be doing Darth Vader, I'll be doing R2-D2, and probably Han Solo somewhere along this section over here. Of course, the Death Star up there, and a couple TIE fighters, and we will have the Star Wars theme together. Over on this side, not as much because they've got some high games, but I'm doing Jurassic Park, so the dinosaurs will be up here peeking out over the top of the games. And that'll continue over here and kind of meet up with the Star Wars over here. But anyways, not so bad for, I don't know, about 3/4 of a day, I guess. Anyways, guys, that's about it. I'm going to go ahead and head on back home to Eugene tonight. However, I might be bringing the motorhome over here to do an extensive stayover so that I can just finish this thing up really quick. Anyways, check this out, and I'll see you in just a moment. Hey guys, how's it going? Got home a little while ago and had some dinner, and now I'm out in the safari trek, jamming on the drums a little bit, sitting by the fire because it's kind of chilly and rainy. Well, not raining right now, but it looks like it's going to at any moment. Be prepared. But a good day. Got the Imperial Walker pretty much there. Tomorrow I will be painting Tatooine. I think that's how you say it. I'm not really a big Star Wars fan. However, these guys kind of wanted a simulation of a Star Wars theme up there in their pizza place. So, hey, I'll paint anything. It doesn't really matter, as you guys can tell. But tomorrow I'll be painting the buildings from Tatooine, and then they'll put in the machines, and then I'll paint a couple various characters in between the machines so they fit in there right. I'll also be painting up some Jurassic Park, quote-unquote, kind of look with some dinosaurs and foliage and those types of things. And I'm going to make a Jurassic Park-style sign, but it's going to say Donatello's. And anyways, really busy painting. After this job is done, I've got another job coming up out in Roseburg again. Of all places, I paint, you know, they either have me come back or their next door neighbors will see stuff I do, and so I end up getting other jobs. So I have another A-frame to paint out there, and a couple other things, some windows. But it's all good. I've been staying real busy, and thank goodness for that. I'm gonna try to take you guys along with me on the trip to Salem in the trek. This will be probably the first official road trek painting trip starting tomorrow, as I will be using this rig to paint windows. And so that's a beautiful thing. And it just shows you guys it can be done. This is all I'm doing now, is just really doing my own thing and enjoying my RV lifestyle. It's been pretty freaking awesome week. I hope you guys are having a great week as well. And I'll be making more videos coming up here soon of other things besides RV and painting, including I'll be doing some Halloween videos coming up here very soon for some people out there that anticipate some cool Halloween videos. So that's on my agenda, and have some pieces filmed already, but I'll be putting it all together in an upcoming cool Halloween / RV video vlog. So until then, you guys, have a wonderful evening. Go out and enjoy your RV. Even if you're not driving it around, you really can enjoy your RV when it's just sitting and being parked and not sucking up fuel. So, you know, go out and use it. Turn on the heater. Turn on your fireplace. Have a beer. Put on the tunes and just enjoy life. All right, guys. This is RV Bandwagon DJ Scott. I'm out.